beat Detroit just 9 days ago in this very building and are 6-1-1 in their last 8 games against the Wings here at Nationwide Arena. And one look at the standings tells you all you need to know about how big tonight's game is. And every night the rest of the way, for that matter. Philly, winners of 8 of their last 10, slid past Detroit last night for the final wildcard spot in the East. Can the Wings reclaim that spot tonight? We shall find out soon. Welcome inside Nationwide Arena as we get you set for the Red Wings and the Blue Jackets here in Columbus tonight. And the news of the day here in Columbus concerns the Red Wings goaltending. Peter Mrazek woke up sick this morning, so Jimmy Howard will get the start tonight. Jared Coro will be his backup. The Wings are in desperate need of 2 points against the Jackets tonight because they do want to reclaim that final spot in the Eastern Conference. However, there's no panic inside that Red Wings dressing room. In fact, Mike Green speaks for the entire group when he talks about the task at hand.
I think we're confident in the sense that we know we can do this. You know, obviously it starts tonight with Columbus. We got to make sure we take the energy out of their building here in the first period and get off to a good start. But we have the composure and the confidence, like I said, in the dressing room to get it done.
So the players are certainly set for this huge tilt in Columbus. What about the broadcasters? Let's take you up to the booth right now and join the guys who will call all the action tonight. Ken Daniels and Chris Osgood. Guys, take it away.
Thank you, Trevor. We're more than set. In losses to the Columbus Blue Jackets last week and recently to Philadelphia over an eight-night span, Chris, the Red Wings were outshot in the opening period 39-7. That's one way to get your goalie in the game, but it's another way to take your team, puts them back on their heels.
It's all about the start for the Red Wings, especially here tonight. This is a must-win for Detroit. They haven't scored a first-period goal in 5 games. Talking with Jeff Blashill today, though, it's about the response after they happen to get scored on, though. It hasn't been very good. He said in Philadelphia, the first 5 minutes didn't mind their start at all. The minute Philadelphia scored that first goal, it was a downward spiral the rest of the first period. He wants a better reaction, a better response from his team if they run into some adversity today. So I look for the Red Wings to play a much sharper first period here in Columbus.
And in Tuesday of last week, a game in which the Red Wings lost, it was a 4-1 game. The Red Wings made it close, then lost 5-3. In the midst of that game, after being badly outshot in the first, Matt Calvert fought Andreas Athanasiou. Athanasiou tried to spark his team because it was all Blue Jackets in terms of physicality.
Now listen, the Columbus Blue Jackets, they cross the line sometimes. This is a physical team, and they'll admit it. They'll go out of their way to make sure they make their presence felt, and they'll do that again tonight. But the Red Wings are going to have a bonus tonight because Prout is not in the lineup. He's suspended for 1 game, and Tootin, he's out with the flu, the big defenseman for Columbus. But Columbus, they're going to forecheck. 2 guys are going to finish every check, and they're going to engage you physically. So the Red Wings are going to have to match that. There you see Athanasiou last game giving his response, but his rest of his teammates have to follow.
So it is a big night indeed for the Red Wings. Henrik Zetterberg looking for his first goal in 12. Zetterberg, Datsyuk, the veterans need to score. And so do Tatar and Nyquist. They've really got to get on track, well off their pace of a year ago. So while the veterans need to produce, it's the youngsters. So the Red Wings hope will continue to bring that youthful enthusiasm. It's the stretch drive for the playoffs. And at the moment, the Red Wings are on the outside trying to get back in.
Meyer. There's more at Meijer. And by Xfinity. X1 from Xfinity will change the way you experience sports.
And on this St. Patrick's Day, everybody's Irish on this day, aren't they? On a happy occasion, and Riley Sheehan would love to have a big night. Brendan Smith, I know. Nick's watching back at home. Ken Daniels, Chris Osgood with you as we bring you our starting goaltenders. Brought to you by your Southeast Michigan Ford dealers. Jimmy Howard, who faced the Blue Jackets in his last start, allowing 4 on 31, but he kept his team in the game in the first. And Sergei Bobrovsky, who didn't play against Detroit last week, hasn't won since December 5th, but he's only had 4 starts since then, including the past 2, giving up 7 goals. Your thoughts, Chris, on Jimmy Howard and what he's facing tonight?
Yeah, didn't find out he was playing until this morning. Jimmy Howard's ready. He's been working hard in practice. I thought his game is where it has to be here late in the season. Working hard with Jim Bedard. I look for a big game from Jimmy Howard here.
Peter Mrazek out with the flu. Jared Coro has been called up from Grand Rapids, where he's been stellar, and he's the backup netminder tonight as Seth Jones is back to get it for the Blue Jackets on defense along with David Savard. Pavel Datsyuk starts up front. With the rookie in his second NHL game, Anthony Mantha, number 39, and Tomáš Tatar, as Datsyuk goes and gets it in back of the net. You can sense the urgency from the Red Wings here even before the game tonight. Datsyuk in back of the net for Mantha. He had four shots on goal in his National Hockey League debut and also hit the iron. Played 14:45 and a strong night for Mantha. It's sent in that Bobrovsky hit the skate of the referee. Big break. Mantha in. Oh, and he couldn't bury it. Oh, that hit the referee, Kyle Raymond, and the Red Wings nearly capitalized. That would have been a break they could have used for sure. Given up in the middle. Here comes Atkinson back in. Takes the shot, and Howard the save. Off to the side for Saad, who put it in back of the goal. Near side controlled here, and Jenner had a shot blocked, brought on here by Dylan Larkin. Larkin over to Abdelkader. Zetterberg heads to the net. It was knocked down as Brandon Saad, who missed the game against the Red Wings last week, back in tonight, along with Cam Atkinson, who gets it deep. Atkinson, one of three Blue Jackets with 24 goals, couldn't get through there. Goes back to the line. Murray's shot, loose in front. Zetterberg there to corral the rebound. Abdelkader tried to chip it past Murray. Kept in by Foligno to the corner. Number 25, another rookie, William Carlson for Columbus. Abdelkader moves one ahead here for Dylan Larkin. Larkin with 20 goals and 40 points in the season. His 188 shots leads Detroit. Zetterberg, the team leader in points with 43. As back to get it goes Brendan Smith, who sent out an Irish tweet to his mother Deirdre today, wishing her a happy St. Paddy's Day, as there's Riley Sheahan working in the corner. Sheahan threw it back to the line to Brendan Smith. To Mike Green, fakes a shot, put it to goal. Loose for Sheahan, and that was stopped by Sergei Bobrovsky. As the Irishman in a great chance in front, Athanasiou just missed a hit. As Brendan Smith goes back to get it. Jimmy Howard played it around through the trapezoid for Green and tipped by Nyquist back into the Columbus zone.
Yeah, well, so far the Red Wings have looked sharper here early in this game. Some great scoring chances. Bobrovsky has been very good here early. Not surprised by the chance that he got. Ricochets off the referee's skate here. The young rookie, Mantha, really wasn't aware. Obviously, it's a skate. Boom, right here. He's got an opportunity. He's in a little bit tight on Bobrovsky. Really no room to make a shot with that at all. And then Sheahan, this is a nice puck movement by the Red Wings here. They get it onto the net. That's what they want to do here in Columbus State and get rebound opportunities. Sheahan unable to elevate that puck and get that high over Bobrovsky's glove. Or he could have made it 1-0.
Riley Sheahan had the shootout winning goal against the Jackets back at Joe Louis Arena. Red Wing win in that meeting and a loss here Tuesday of last week, 5-3. And it was the visitors' own undoing. It was a 4-1 game till the Red Wings made it 4-3 late. Came loose into the crease, and Jimmy Howard will get a glove on that, and he'll hold on. Well, Jeff Blashill, Chris, was not happy with the way his team gave the puck away and outshot so badly, 23-3 in the first period in Philadelphia.
Yeah, and so far here in Columbus, I'm seeing a lot of similarities to the Ranger game. They're getting pucks deep behind the Columbus defense, cycling it down low. They're not giving it away. They're holding on to it, getting the puck back to the point, getting shots through the traffic. Look for that as this game continues.
And that Ranger win was one of the most thorough. They won in overtime on Darren Helm's goal, 3-2.
And that's kind of why I was so surprised they played such a solid 60-minute game and they got away from it the next game. It seems so far here in Columbus they've kind of gotten back to that so far.
And that next game was a 1-0 loss at Joe Louis Arena to the Maple Leafs, followed up by the 4-3 loss in Philadelphia, which brings us to this night where Mantha and company are a point out of the playoff chase, looking up at Philadelphia and Carolina's at Pittsburgh tonight. Pittsburgh, 3 up on Detroit with the game in hand. Carolina is only 4 back. And they are even in games.
And you do not want a three-point game in that hockey game. You want somebody to win that game in regulation.
Philadelphia and Pittsburgh will meet 3 more times, and how many of those will be three-point games? And that's why when the Red Wings had their fate in their own hands to lose games to the Jackets last week in Toronto, that's what really hurts.
Those are the 3 games that are worrisome, because if 2 go to a 3-point, suddenly both teams are getting heck of a lot of points. The Red Wings got to win extra games here moving forward.
Puck in back of the net, grabbed there by Quincy, around for Mantha. Mantha got knocked off the puck, loose into the slot. Atkinson couldn't pick it up. Columbus, though, gets to it first as Murray slides one back in for Atkinson. Quincy cleared it. Brandon Saad can't get over to keep it in. Saad, who came over from Chicago June of last year in a multiplayer deal with Artem Anisimov going to the Blackhawks. He's fit in nicely in the hole there behind Jonathan Toews down the middle for Chicago. Marco Dano, a prospect, went from Columbus to Chicago, and then Chicago sent Dano to Winnipeg in the Andrew Ladd deal. Foligno got it in back of the net. Marchenko around to the line, kept in by Savard. And as Chris mentioned in our open, the Blue Jackets without Dalton Proud tonight and Fedor Tootin on their back end. So two big losses for them, and Jack Johnson gone for the season following shoulder surgery. The Jackets playing for pride here and to try to impress head coach John Tortorella for next season. Tortorella saying this morning it is experiment time. We're looking to next season. We're putting players in different spots to see what they can do. While he said, quote, we're being accountable to the game because there are other teams who want us to beat the Red Wings tonight. And they've got to play the games because there are others who would like them to ice a lineup that is as competitive as possible and play the way the game should be played.
The Blue Jackets always play solid against the Red Wings. 10-2-2 record in the last 14. This team always plays physical and gives us tons of trouble.
Quickly ahead for Calvert. Matt Calvert getting it in. He had that fight with Andreas Athanasiou in the last meeting up there along with number 9, Gregory Campbell. He won a cup with the Bruins in 2011. Son of Colin Campbell. He heads the National Hockey League and been very busy at the general manager's meetings in Boca Raton this week. Just wrapping up. We'll bring you more on that. And some changes perhaps as this game progresses. Dubinsky couldn't get through. One of those changes tonight. Dubinsky playing the wing, and Howard with a save there off Oliver Bjorkstrand in his first National Hockey League game. Number 28 for Columbus. A big score, and Junior hails from Denmark. Center, and Bjorkstrand tried to knock it down. Richards couldn't get to the line. Dubinsky lets it go to the far side for Alexander Wenberg, number 41 of the Blue Jackets. Loose at center ice and backhanded deep by Glendening. And the Red Wings will get a wholesale change.
Well, Bjorkstrand, he's got some speed to him. You can tell he's got a nice skill set. And a nice shot. Jimmy Howard was able to make a big save earlier.
Marchenko a couple of whacks at that puck. Out at center here for Mantha. Mantha for Datsyuk. Datsyuk going wide. Datsyuk circling the goal. Still with it. Had nowhere to go. He gets chopped at by Boone Jenner. Golubov. Able to get it ahead for Saad. Good pass, knocked down, kicked there by Atkinson. Atkinson drops for Jenner. Jenner going wide with it back to Atkinson and just missed the net. What a pretty setup that was for the Blue Jackets.
Red Wings got away with one here. Beautiful setup, and Atkinson just unable to put that into the open net. Kind of shanked it to the right of Jimmy Howard.
Back into the Columbus zone. Atkinson scored a couple of goals for the Blue Jackets in the 5-3 win here last week, including an empty netter after he had hit the goalpost. Good save there by Howard on a redirect. Loose here, picked up by Larkin. Larkin coming in, pulls it back, and the shot whistled wide, high, over the glove hand of Bobrovsky. Zetterberg with some good work. There's going to be a penalty here to Columbus. So the Red Wings are going to head to a Bell Tire power play as they check with Dylan Larkin over at the Red Wing bench. Red Wings, man advantage when we come back. Box, they've called high sticking on this. Let's see.
It looked like to be more of a shoulder here. Carlson kind of reversed it in, and Larkin just grazed the shoulder. Really not much there. I'm not going to say he sold it a bit, but maybe he did.
Didn't look like the stick came up, but at any rate, the Red Wings will take it, although it's a power play that has not gone well for them. And 25th in the league. Is that the definition of perplexed?
He doesn't look like he's too happy, but this is a big opportunity for the Red Wings here. Just under 8 minutes into this game, they have a chance. They get a power play here early, power play goal here early. A team that takes a lot of penalties, maybe they get some confidence, and tonight could be the night their power play suddenly gets off the snide and gets hot here.
John Tortorella's thinking, you nearly gave them a goal off your skate and now penalty. Not happy early on. So the Red Wings go to a Bell Tire power play. Time like the present. Datsyuk tried to feed it back, wouldn't go. Out along with Mantha, swings it around near side for Green. Tatar in behind. Good recovery there by Mantha to prevent the Blue Jackets from getting out. Richards down low. Richards with it again. And the shot goes off the stick of Seth Jones. Up into the protective netting and a stop in play. So the faceoff will stay in the Columbus zone. Anthony Mantha, four shots on goal in his debut.
And he's had some impressive defensive. That's a nice steal there as well. Gets it over to Richards here, then he heads towards the goal. His overall game has really improved in Grand Rapids, and that's why he got the call-up. He has the offensive ability, but he's also taken over defensively.
Matsuk just sent it wide. Tatar checked by Campbell. Calvert forcing the issue here for Columbus. Brad Richards brings it ahead for the Red Wings. Richards along with Mantha. Play just onside. Mantha in there against Kalibach. To the point kept in by Green. Datsu quickly. Tatar, a shot saved by Bobrovsky. Ryan Murray couldn't clear. Tatar for Green. Another shot just missed. And cleared by Gregory Campbell.
Some good opportunities by the Red Wings. They moved the puck a lot quicker. That second unit, once they got out there, Green's got to hit the net there. They're not getting a lot of opportunities. Columbus Blue Jackets are good at blocking shots from the point and figure a way to get those through with some traffic in front of Bobrovsky.
Red Wings 0 for 5 on the power play the past two games. They only had 2 minutes and 10 seconds on it against Philadelphia. Kept in by DeKaiser, but not on a second try. Flipped down the ice with a half minute to go in this man advantage for Detroit. Columbus is penalty killing, 15th in the league, 12th best at home. They've killed off 36 times shorthanded of 41 the past dozen games, so it's been very good. But they've been shorthanded a lot, most penalized team in the league. Abdelkader, DeKaiser, intended feed knocked down by Atkinson as Nyquist back to get it. And out of the box is Carlson. So the Red Wings 0-for-1 man advantage tonight.
Hey Ken, they got to really just simplify this power play. Two passes, get the puck to the net. They're standing still in the perimeter. They're not getting any opportunity. They're not moving the puck quick enough. It's two passes, shoot at the net. Creates a screen in front of Bobrovsky. Get it bounced. That's how you're going to score right now. It's too many pretty passes. Got to simplify that.
Just one shot on that last power play. Tip from across center by Glendening. Bobrovsky played it in back of the net. Then Ryan Murray tries to seal Glendening there. It came free near side. Athanasiou backhand, but couldn't get it through. Murray lifted one out to center for Carlson. Carlson pulls it back, got knocked down. He went down on his own though with the stick there. The fans here, the Columbus fans, wanted a trip, but that didn't appear to be. Drop back here for Shane with a shot. Scores! On St. Paddy's Day, Riley Shane makes it 1-0.
And this is set up by Athanasiou. Uses his speed, creates space. Glendening goes to the net in front of Bobrovsky, creates a screen. But this is what speed does. Because Athanasiou gets in, pushes back the Columbus Blue Jacket defense, puts it back to Shane. Look at Glendening, perfect positioning in front of Bobrovsky. Might even run off Glendening. We'll find out soon here. But that's a textbook goal by the Red Wings. And that's exactly what Jeff Blaschel is looking for. The pushback by Athanasiou of the Columbus Blue Jacket defense. Glendening goes to the net, creates that screen in front of Bobrovsky, who can't see the shot. Shane with a perfect shot, wings up by one.
So again, the shootout winner against the Blue Jackets earlier this season, and he's got his 10th goal and his 18th point. 1-0 Detroit, as the Red Wings have scored a first period goal.
I was going to say, that's a huge confidence builder for them.
First time in 6 games the Red Wings have scored a goal in the first. The opposition had scored first in each of their past 7.
I would say that's the biggest goal scored all year by a Red Wing player right there. They needed that. They needed the first goal in this game, and a game that they have to have.
Tipped at center ice and into Detroit territory. The Red Wings have the first goal for the first time in 8 games. And as you can see, going into the game tonight, the last 7, they held the lead for just over 4.5 minutes. And yet this was a Red Wing team that had 1 goal leads in the third period by far and away earlier on, it was a month ago, more than any other team in the National Hockey League. Here's Atkinson back in. Atkinson waits, shoots off a stick. Howard covered short side off the kick plate. He was able to keep it in back of the net. Zetterberg pushed to the boards, regained control though. Great work by the Red Wings captain. Ahead for Dylan Larkin. Here comes Saad back in. Saad with a jump on Smith. A shot, and Howard with a save there. Zetterberg just cleared it out of harm's way. Ryan Murray back. Murray, the second overall pick in 2012. On defense with 26-year-old Cody Galliba. Murray with a good move. He's been healthy this year after missing most of last season due to injury. So Riley Sheahan from Athanasiou and Marchenko, 10-23. The Red Wings with a 1-0 first period. St. Patrick's Day, Luke Glendening gets his first goal in 22 games. Riley Sheahan's shot hits him, Chris.
Yeah, right on the right knee of Glendening. You get rewarded when you do good things. Heads towards the net, creates a screen from Bobrovsky. Hits Glendening on the right knee on the inside, off Bobrovsky and into the net. Red Wings getting a huge goal. I said before, I think that's their biggest goal of the year in a must-win game here in Columbus.
Red Wings 2-5. Their past seven games. Each team coming in here has lost their past two. Columbus has lost two since their last win, and that was against Detroit. So that scoring play will be Glendening from Sheahan and Athanasiou at 10-23. Drop back to the line. Moved in deep by Bjorkstrand. It goes off him. He goes and gets it. Moves it to the line to Seth Jones. And a shot by Savard. And no one's sure where that is. It's off in the corner. We'll get a stop in play. We'll be part of the farewell season at the Joe by placing a small deposit on the 2016-17 season ticket plan. You'll get priority access to seating locations in the new Detroit Event Center and other exclusive benefits. For more information, call 313-471-7575 now. Ticket executives are standing by. Shots. And the way things have gone lately for this team in first periods, that says something too. That's a bouncing puck high at center, picked up here by Nick Foligno, who had a great season last year, but not quite the same this season for Foligno. Following a concussion, trying to regain his confidence. The Blue Jackets captain in back of the net, checked by Marchenko. Good job by Marchenko to tie him up. The Blue Jackets still with it, and now there's going to be a penalty coming, called by the center ice referee Chris Rooney. And let's see who's going here. It looks to be a Blue Jackets penalty as
43 Columbus 2 minutes high sticking.
So Hartnell's going to go to the box. Scott Hartnell for high sticking, and here at skate this morning, Nick Cronwall, who was to be 1 to 3 weeks away, has been out for one. And then here in the pregame skate tonight, Chris, they knew he wasn't going to play, but he took the skate. This just tells me he's champing at the bit to get going.
It's hard to keep him out, Ken. This guy wants to play regardless. He'll be back soon, later. I even suspect possibly back against the Florida Panthers. Which would be great news
for the schedule.
2 weeks ahead of schedule, but they definitely need him back there. His leadership in the room really adds to that as well, but missing Nicholas Mahler, you just can't replace a player like that.
Well, that wasn't dropped fairly as the Red Wings go to their second Bell Tire power play with Hartnell in the box.
Now, Ken, this is a big chance. They're up 1-0 here. They can take a 2-0 lead. A lot of times over the last month, their power play has not been able to get that goal for them when they needed it. Right here, they have a chance.
Zetterberg able to keep that in for Nyquist. Nyquist cuts to the middle. Hangs onto it here for Green. To Henrik Zetterberg at the right point. Watched by Atkinson, who forced him. And then sent down the ice by Brandon Dubinsky. Another one of those changes that John Tortorella has made, moving Dubinsky from center to the wing. Said he's a good soldier, not all that happy about it, but just all part of the Blue Jackets trying to see what they've got going forward for next season. Here they're trying to kill off a Red Wing power play. Loose puck for Green. Nyquist ties up his man. Green has it back at the line for Larkin, fanned on it, and that allowed Calvert to get it out of the Columbus zone. Backpedaling Green moves one ahead here for Nyquist at center. Nyquist checked on the way back, but moved it to Zetterberg. Off to an open wing and just stays inside the zone. Mantha off the bench. Mantha to the front of the net. And that's cleared away by Columbus.
Mantha with a very long reach. Should have elected to shoot initially. He has a great, great shot. He had Bobrovsky back in his net a bit. Listen, as a goalie, he doesn't know Mantha. He doesn't know his shot. So if I was Mantha, I'd take as many shots as I could right now. You'd catch him off guard.
Richards back for Tatar. Open is Mantha. Too hot to handle. Tatar able to knock it down for Richards. Put it toward the net. Bobrovsky able to clear that one away. And again, Bobrovsky, as we mentioned, hasn't played very much. And injured most of the past 3 months with a groin issue.
You have to think, Ken, if Mantha continues to get these chances, first two games he's played, he's had a ton. He's going to get one sooner or later.
Sooner would be nice.
Be very nice.
Brendan Smith back to get it. He's got no points in 12 games. But he's not alone in that regard. Gets it back as Columbus returns to full strength. Hartnell out of the box. Glendening the goal scorer, but the Red Wings go offside. It's brought in by Athanasiou. While the Penguins are trailing the Hurricanes, who are trailing the Red Wings by 4. Pittsburgh 3 up. Highlights when we come back. Osgood back in 2013 was Jared Coral, then signed by the Red Wings out of Northern Michigan. 6'6 netminder as he was called up to back up Jimmy Howard tonight with Peter Mrazek having the flu, and it was Mrazek's scheduled start. But Howard gets the call, and Coral, who's been outstanding in Grand Rapids. How about those Griffins? 12 consecutive wins to go along with a 15-game winning streak earlier this season. Remarkable.
Coral's progressed nicely. First year pro, Ken. One win. That's it. All year long. It's tough, and we do bounce back. He's having a great year this year with the Griffins.
He's 6-0 his past six. A broken stick there from Athanasiou, his teammate in Grand Rapids. Coral 6-0 his past six. Bobrovsky handles that one. 3 shutouts and a 967 save percentage.
And him and Thomas McCullum both have save percentage 930. That's incredible this year. Griffin's getting great goaltending.
In that 12-game winning streak, they've only allowed 12 goals. Here's Datsyuk. Datsyuk on a steal and a backhand. Going to the net, Helm, and he just missed it. Good hustle by Mantha coming back. And then it hit his back, and now Mantha's got it. Mantha's in. Mantha backhand, forehand, and he lost an edge and went down. Nice play in his second National Hockey League game, but he looks to be hurt. Anthony Mantha not up yet. And Pete Van Zandt's making his way to the ice.
Yeah, let's hope he's okay. He's got a stinger there going into the net, but while the puck seems to be following Mantha around, it has been for 2 games since his call-up. He's had plenty of opportunity to score here. Off the rear of the puck goes. Listen, quick first step by Mantha to get around the defender here and had an opportunity. Just went down. Post got right in the rib cage there. That stings. That's going to hurt a bit. Hopefully he's okay. Right there. That's not good. Right in the rib cage. There's no padding there for Mantha at all. That's not going to keep him out though. Got called up. He's 2 games in.
Boy, Coro at 6'6", Mantha at 6'5". This Red Wing team's getting a whole lot bigger with just a couple of additions, and it was nice to see his parents. Trevor Thompson spoke with them in Philadelphia. Daniel and Susie were in the crowd, made the 7-hour drive with his 2 older sisters, Barbara and Elizabeth, to come down from Montreal for the game in Philly.
Wow, did they ever look excited in the crowd as well. Great game, great first game to be at. Unfortunately, the Red Wings didn't pull it out. I've been impressed with Mantha these first 2 games of his young NHL career. Follows that puck around. He's got better defensively as well, but wow, he has some offensive upside that you're going to see as a Red Wing fan moving forward.
So with 3.5 to go in the first, he's gone to the room. This will be icing against Columbus, and let's revisit that first game for Anthony Mantha in Philadelphia, Chris.
And not an easy place to play. Philadelphia's a difficult place. This is a huge game. I thought he fit right in. How did that ever happen? First shot on that partial breakaway, stick breaks, but he had plenty of opportunity off the post there. Mom's nervous sitting there watching that go off the post, but I was impressed not only with his offensive ability, but his 50-50 battles. He won a lot of battles on the boards against a big, strong Philadelphia team. Impressive player, and he will be a star here in Detroit one day.
That puck nearly glanced off referee Chris Rooney. Just got out of the way. Been involved tonight. Abdelkader getting back to chop it off Larkin to center. And Seth Jones will send it back in, playing in his 29th game with Columbus. Whoa, that came right in on Howard as Zetterberg ran out of real estate, had nowhere to go as Smith gave him the puck. And that was close.
This is the play that's been hurting Detroit lately. I mean, last year, Erickson had a giveaway in front of the net in Philadelphia, but the Red Wings used to always do these plays up the middle, and they're just not working as much as they used to work, and teams seem to know that they're doing it. They jump all over this right away, that inside of the ice there. Smith goes to Zetterberg, who has no room whatsoever to move that puck, and it didn't cost the Red Wings, fortunately.
Gulliva put it off the backboards, and Jimmy Howard will get that trapper on it, and he'll hang on. See that trapper he's got there? They're not going to make any adjustments to that for next season. We'll have more on that, but that cheater they have on the trapper there, that wide part, they're not going to take that off the gloves for next year, nor will they work on the goalie pads for next season, nor the sweaters. They will have other changes we'll tell you about as this game progresses. But those changes will have to wait a year or so, but the goalies will look different next year for sure. Green back to get it. Checked by Calvert. Put it back into the corner for Chaput. To the line. Just kept in by Gulliva. Backhands it. Green over there to get it for Detroit. Couldn't clear it. Calvert kept it in. Second try. Now the Red Wings move it. And Richards looked to his left. It went to his right. And there will be an icing. And the faceoff will come back into the Detroit zone.
The reason why the Red Wings have been successful here in the first period is they've dealt with Columbus's forecheck very well, better than they did the previous game here in Columbus. Columbus likes to forecheck two guys coming after you, be physical. The Red Wings' first passes have been great, other than when Smith went to Zetterberg. They've been pretty crisp getting out of their own zone, and that's been a difference here in the first.
Columbus wins that faceoff and then lost the puck. Taken away, hooked is Athanasiou, and there's no call. Athanasiou in, pulled it back, and Bobrovsky made the save. Boy, surprising, no hooking call on that play, as Athanasiou clearly was on the way back. Across it goes for Helm. To the net goes Mantha. And the shot was blocked by Jones. Mantha with it. To the line, Marchenko. That shot was blocked in front. Atkinson gets hit by his number 13 counterpart, Pavel Datsyuk. Interference thrown into Helm. Seth Jones off on the wing here for Foligno, who's checked, who bumps with Marchenko. Datsyuk got it to center ice. Ryan Murray for Columbus. 1:20 to go in the opening period. In goes Scott Hartnell. Hartnell with 21 goals on the season. One of four 20 goal scorers in this Jackets team. Shot was blocked in front. Moved in deep for Hartnell. Golubov in back of the net. Erickson got a stick in there. Then it comes back for Hartnell again, who went down. And that's nothing unusual for him. Here's Nyquist. Even gives to a charity when it's Hartnell down for how many times he falls in a game. Foligno. Jones shoots one. Carried out by Green. Green ahead for Riley Sheahan. Here comes Zetterberg. Zetterberg's in. Zetterberg wanted to throw it back in front. Had nobody open. Still has it, and the shot missed the net. Green put it back into the middle, and the Jackets just clear it right back to him. Now Sheahan. 10 seconds to go in the opening period. Dubinsky bumped his man. Carried out through. Here comes Bjorkstrand. The Dane is in. Knocked off his stick. Puck into the corner, and the Red Wings, after 20 minutes, not only outshoot the Jackets, Red Wings player of the game presented by McDonald's. Stop by for your breakfast favorites, now being served all day.
And a scouting report. Oakland University brings you the scouting report. Anthony Mantha played over just over 5 minutes in the first period. Got two shots, but gotta love the way he's playing. This kid is young. Yes, great offensive ability. He drives to the net. Coach Jeff Rocha loves this. Takes two Columbus Blue Jackets with him. Opens up space here. Nice nifty move here. Almost got this through. Kravoski just about here. Just misses the puck here. God, he's got a lot of chances here in his first two games since he's been called up. Got to think he's going to get one here soon, driving the net there. He's okay after a big collision with the net. Got to be impressed so far with Mantha. He's really come along Grand Rapids this year. You can see the progression. He looks good.
And he's starting on the right wing. Datsyuk in the middle. Darren Helm on the left. As Helm starting in place of Tatar on that left side where Tatar had started the game. Jonathan Erickson going back on defense with Marchenko. Erickson being chased, tapped it around, picked up there by Atkinson, tried to center for Dubinsky, who couldn't. Dubinsky finished his hit on Pavel Datsyuk. Mantha checked, coughed it up. Atkinson threw it in down low to Wennberg. Good save by Howard, went short side, and he stopped Alexander Wennberg. He was more of a passer than a shooter, but took a shot there. Howard got a piece of that. It was redirected. Dubinsky, some good work. Getting it back to the line, kept in there by Savard. Dubinsky came over, knocked it away. Atkinson to the middle, picked up by Anthony Mantha. Mantha to center. Slides one into the jacket zone so the Red Wings can get a change. Moved quickly by Savard, sensing that change, and tipped in, so no icing. Jimmy Howard back for Kyle Quincy. Knocked in back of the goal by Boone Jenner. Zetterberg able to get control of that puck, lifts one down ice. Larkin went to pick it up, but the play is called offside at the Columbus Blue Jackets blue line. Join us again Saturday on Fox Sports Detroit Plus when the Red Wings head to Florida to take on Jakob Kindle and the Panthers. Our coverage begins at 6:30 with Red Wings Live. Red Wings and Panthers in Yager Saturday at 6:30 on Fox Sports Detroit Plus. And they are in Toronto tonight. A goalless first period. The Panthers and the Maple Leafs. And Roberto Luongo, and what a season Florida is having. And Vincent Trocheck and company. And Spuddy Gallant back of their bench has done such a nice job. Gerard Gallant. And Dale Tallon rebuilding that team. Pulls some high draft picks help in that regard. But he's done a nice job in selecting.
He made some nice deals at the trade deadline.
Yep.
Yuri Hudler's there.
Yuri Hudler, right?
Take yourself from there. Edmonton is there now. They've really got some depth. They've got four good lines they can throw at you, and ultra-talented power plays. So the Wings, after this game, are going to have to be their sharpest when they head to Florida.
And Jakob Kindle's been playing a third defense pair there with Petrovic.
And I always said he had some potential. I really liked his progression here the last two seasons. He was very good last year. At the end of last year, he was in the second power play. So he always had the potential. I think he just needed another opportunity. Change of scenery has done him well.
Foligno got it out to center, then Calvert. As that goes into the Red Wing bench, so we'll get a stop in play. And playing his first game of the season and his second in the National Hockey League, son of former NHLer Rob Ramage, that is John, who played one game with Calgary. John was born during Rob's time as captain of the Maple Leafs. 16 years Rob Ramage played with eight teams in the NHL. And his son John playing in his second National Hockey League game, drafted by Calgary, played one with Calgary, and wearing a familiar number 55 that his dad had worn at times in his career.
Solid player. A lot of sons of the fathers are playing in the NHL right now. Tkachuk's son will be a high draft pick this year.
Called offside as John Ramage tried to get it in.
The Winnipeg Jets. Tkachuk was drafted by.
Yep.
Could pick his son. I mean, that's, he's right there. Top five pick in the Jets in all likelihood. We're picking somewhere around there. Lots of players.
Well, all around that era, well, Ty Domi and Max Domi. So yeah, many.
I'm really impressed with Max Domi. He's got his dad's competitiveness, but wow, he's got that offensive ability. The kid has had an unreal season.
Nice skills. William Carlson, the rookie, gets waved out, so the veteran Campbell comes in against Athanasiou and won that faceoff. Athanasiou with Richards and Glendening. Puck is sent down ice. Out to play it is Sergei Bobrovsky. Ramage moved it. Campbell getting it ahead here for Carlson. He gets knocked down and a penalty coming to Quincy. Holding will be the call.
And I'm not so sure about this. Unless Quincy took that left hand off his stick and
threw down the Columbus player, but really, unlike before, with Erickson Tatar, who didn't figure out the two-on-two, Athanasiou and Quincy did a great job of really sorting this out and making sure the Columbus blue jackets didn't get a chance. To me, this is a tough play on Carlson. Quincy, just a big physical player, out-muscled the player for Columbus and knocked him down. To me, that's not a penalty. That's just a good puck battle won by Quincy.
So the Jackets go to the power play now. They're first of the game, and the Red Wings had a couple. And it's Wennberg for Jenner to Murray at the point. Cam Atkinson took a shot off the target. Alexander Wennberg. Back to the line, knocked away, and cleared by Glenn Denning. Jackets power play 19th in the league, 0 for 7 their past two games. Scott Hartnell with 9 power play goals, Boone Jenner with 8. They're the leaders as Jenner puts it in to the left wing offensive corner. Tapped around in back of the net. Loose puck, Sheahan trying to get a stick on it. Pop free, Brendan Smith nudged it ahead but not out. Columbus in control. Off the stick of Helm, gets it back, moved by Sheahan. Catching up is Smith. Helm leads him, Smith in, and he sent it wide of the goal. Nice play though, Helm and Brendan Smith. Good opportunity shorthanded for Detroit. Murray in deep, the defenseman. Comes to the line, Savard moved it, Foligno back to Dubinsky. For Savard, to Ryan Murray near side. Tipped in front of the goal and rolled through, and Howard able to hold on.
Nice shorthanded opportunity here by the Red Wings. Darren Helm using his speedy stroke. A lot of offensive ability here of late, but Brendan Smith jumps up into play. Nice offensive awareness by Brendan Smith to create that opportunity. But look at Smith, get on his high horse, gets through. Uses speed to get past the Columbus Blue Jacket player. Just tapped it wide of Bobrovsky, but nice heads-up play. Smart hockey play by Smith.
Jackets hold it in with 20 seconds left on the man advantage. Dubinsky moved it. Foligno in front, off Hartnell. Abdelkader gets it down the ice. That'll do it. On the Blue Jackets power play there, first of the game. Out of the box comes Quincy. And Dubinsky brings it right in and then lost it as a diving to Kaiser came over. And that was an interesting play because I think Quincy could have flattened him. Dubinsky at center coming out of the box and elected not to, and Dubinsky wound up with a good opportunity.
Dubinsky undressed Marchenko. Quincy noticing that made a great play to come across and take away that passing angle.
Nyquist from across center got it in and got it back. There's a shot and it was blocked. Zetterberg in back of the net. Nyquist in too close. Zetterberg took a shot off the goalpost. Nyquist now with it. Nyquist waits to the line to Smith. Doesn't shoot it. And a penalty upcoming here against Detroit for interference. Just as Green was set to move in.
Zetterberg's going to go for the interference here. Everyone got the turnover, creating a ton of pressure on the Jackets. And to me, once again, there's been some calls here tonight. The Columbus player went down fairly easy there. And Zetterberg just battling for position there in front of Borowski again. And the Red Wings a lot more tenacious in front of both nets. You saw it at the end of the penalty kick for the Wings. And there you saw it off a turnover. The Red Wings weren't happy just with the one chance. They wanted more. Continued the pressure on the Columbus Blue Jackets. And unfortunately, Zetterberg gets an interference penalty in front of the net.
So another Columbus man advantage. Off the draw, picked up by Abdelkader. With Glenn Denning. That's Bjorkstrand gets it around near side and getting it back now. Left there for Murray. For Wennberg, skate the stick. Jenner on the left wing. Abdelkader took it from Atkinson. left there for Murray. Good work by Sheehan along with Helm. Sheehan again and a bouncing puck to the corner. Here's a loose puck. Murray coming over. Sheehan trying to get it through and he couldn't do it. Helm was open and in, but Riley Sheehan just couldn't find the puck.
Yeah, I think that had to do with Riley Sheehan was just out of gas out there for quite some time. Just couldn't get a handle on that puck in his feet to get it across the Helm. He would have been in alone.
You could see his reaction there. He knew he had him. Brandon Saad gets it in. 24 goals, 41 points for Saad. Seth Jones back to get it. A goal and 15 points in 28 games coming into play tonight with the Blue Jackets. Came over for Ryan Johansson in January in a deal with Nashville. Johansson's played 30 games with the Predators. 5 goals and 20 points. The centerman as Howard holds on to that Saad shot. And in case you're just joining us in the first period for the first time in 6 games, the Red Wings got a goal in the opening 20 and it goes off Glendening off a Riley Sheehan attempt.
Yes, textbook goal by the Red Wings. After Nasil using his speed once again, pushing the Jackets defense back and getting heading towards the net, creating the screen. Sheehan, the shot off the right knee of Glendening in. Biggest goal of the year for me so far by the Red Wings.
Face-off win there by Detroit. As much you talk, the referees on both sides, even the Blue Jackets, who are looking at a first overall pick more than they are anything else for the standings, were upset that there wasn't a penalty called on the Red Wings' Marchenko for dumping Carlson at the other end when the Red Wings broke out on the rush. See, it goes both ways. Nobody's happy with officials. That's how it works. Zetterberg out of the box, and here he comes. Henrik Zetterberg, chased there by Foligno, captain on captain. Green getting it back from Larkin, and then Green is checked. Calvert, Green trying to get it back. Calvert with it. Threw it around to the other side, loose puck, Columbus first on it. Nyquist with a check, as Zetterberg able to move it. Ahead for Larkin. Sends it where Nyquist is going to the left wing offensive corner. Zetterberg. Larkin now for Detroit. Larkin with a good move to get away there from Justin Falk, who was called up to the American Hockey League this morning. Green with a shot, held by Bobrovsky, as Falk was called up with the illness to Fedor Tuten. You're watching Red Wings Hockey on Fox Sports Detroit. Per body, well, the general manager's meeting's just concluding in Boca Raton, Florida, and some of the changes they have made for next season, Chris, for the manufacturers, contoured chest protectors and arm padding, and goaltenders to have contoured goalie pants. Your thoughts?
Well, the difference now is they have the goalies going along with it. Hopley, as well as Schneider, other goalies in the National Hockey League, they're really pushing this forward, and they want this to happen. Before, when I played, the goalies didn't want the changes. They wanted the equipment to stay the same. So to me, they can't change everything at once. The arm pads are going to remove that big pad that's on the shoulder. That's not going to stick out. They're going to be more contoured to the body. And the pads, I think that's going to be the big difference. A lot of these guys wear some huge, huge pads. You're going to see now the opportunity for players to score higher above the five hole between the thighs.
And we'll, in a few moments, tell you what they haven't done for next season, but for the year after, they will be looking after that. So changes will be coming, and those are two for next year. And Saad gets knocked down by Smith, similar to what happened with Quincy, but that one was not called. The Red Wings say thanks on that. As it's cleared back down ice, Golubev for Columbus. Picked up here by Marchenko, and a shot just deflected wide as Tatar tried to get to him. So Tatar out with... Well, he'll go off in a change now, and over the boards comes Zetterberg as Tatar was out with Datsyuk and Mantha. Zetterberg comes on now with Dylan Larkin. Off his stick, going to chase. Loose puck, but Ryan Murray's got it. Just sent it out to center. Jonathan Erickson into the skates of Zetterberg, but managed to keep control of it. For Dylan Larkin, plays onside. Zetterberg working on Murray. Zetterberg back of the net. And then Murray did... good job to contain him. Kept in by Marchenko momentarily. And Golubev has it for the Blue Jackets. Red Wings in the midst. taste of a change as we approach the halfway point in this game. Ken Daniels, Chris Osgood with you from Nationwide Arena. Glad you're with us tonight on Fox Sports Detroit. Here comes Athanasiou, who helped set up the opening goal. Look at that great speed, dropped it back. And the pass across for Richards just failed to click on a feed there from Nyquist. The Red Wings, as we pass the halfway point, still looking for their first shot of this middle frame. Columbus with six so far. Here's Richards. And Bobrovsky will hold it in that padding, those big pants of his, and will continue to tell you what hasn't changed yet for goaltending equipment for next season when we come back. For goaltenders next season, what they haven't done is decide to streamline the sweaters for next season. That'll come the year after, and you'll get another look. Look at this, Chris, how the sweater's so big.
When I was in studio, that drove me nuts, but when I played, I loved wearing a jersey like that.
You did,
because... A lot of saves like that, but when I saw that, I'm like, wow, they got to make a change to that. Now I was a fan watching him. Of course I want more goals, but...
Look at your sweater. That's a tent.
Hey, that jersey helped raise that cup, so don't rip that jersey. That jersey
That's a tent.
No way. That thing is tight.
That was wow. That was 98. My goodness, it's come
unreal.
Down quite a bit since
I think
then.
Ken Holland took some heat at the general manager's meeting for that jersey, so...
So it's your fault.
I apologize to him for that, and that's probably what started this whole thing with the jersey, so I apologize to all the goalies as well.
Stolen here by Tatar, back to Datsyuk. Nice little Datsyuk EMD right there. Just couldn't find anyone in front. So the sweaters have been narrowed since Chris Osgood's days in the late 90s, but still need to be more. As Jones took a shot, deflected wide, Howard knocked down in front, right there with Chaput at the periphery of the crease. Behind the net here for Foligno. Foligno moved it to the line. Jones across to Savard, blocked by Mantha. Kept in on the backhand by Jones in tight quarters. Mantha's stick is broken. And then Smith knocked down. Foligno wanted a call. Mantha without a stick. Stepped into Jones. And a smart play there because Mantha knew he couldn't go back because his stick was there. And Mantha just took his ice away. Green back to get it. Long stretch pass. Clicked off the stick. Oh, it didn't. Athanasiou thought he touched
it.
Just
like
missed
it.
And that's why there'll be icing. He's mad at himself, so I guess he didn't. And the linesmen were right.
Himself and Helmut have been off to the races. They were pretty much guaranteed a grade A scoring chance.
And those two off to the races, that would be quite the race. Athanasiou and Helmut.
I love watching Athanasiou. To see you play. Regardless of the minutes he plays each and every game, he makes a difference. You notice him on the ice. If he plays 7 minutes, you notice him out there. If he plays 12, that just knows how to play. He gets some fights. He finishes checks. He's good defensively. And has shown some great offensive ability as well. Very impressed so far after he's been called up.
Averaging just over 9 minutes ice time a night, and yet in the 25 games he's played, or now 26, he's got 6 goals and 10 points in 26 games, averaging 9 minutes a night.
And that's part of being a young player. You have to make the most of what you're given, and he has definitely done that.
Saved by Howard, and his shooting percentage is over 17%. As Athanasiou got it over to Helm. Datsyuk goes off in a change as Nyquist comes on for him. Smith played it to no one in particular, so Howard has to go back and get it. Back for Brendan Smith. Justin Falk back to get it. And a different one than the one who plays... Still in Carolina. As Falk is back to touch, and the faceoff will come back down ice. Again, you just called up from the Lake Erie Monsters this afternoon due to some injuries on the back end for the Blue Jackets, who also do not have David Clarkson up front, who scored against the Red Wings here last week. So they're missing Tootin, Prout, and Johnson on the blue line.
I think the Red Wings give them full credit here. 7 minutes to go, just over in the second period, and they've played well defensively. They've been a lot more tenacious in front of their net, a lot sharper with their passing out of their zone, and have dealt with the forecheck of the Columbus Blue Jackets a heck of a lot better than they did the last time they're in this building. So far the Red Wings full marks for leading this hockey game 1-0. They're playing the way they want to.
The last 2 months, last month and this month, Columbus and the Detroit Red Wings with the exact same records. Marchenko iced it, went wide of the net, and the faceoff, same place. Limited tickets available to see the Red Wings take on the Montreal Canadiens, the Pittsburgh Penguins, the Philadelphia Flyers, whom they're trailing by a point now, and more in the last five regular season home games of this season. For tickets, call 313-471-7575 now. Ticket executives are standing by. Pittsburgh and Carolina playing tonight. Pittsburgh 3 up on the Red Wings, Carolina 4 back. Mickey York will have highlights for you in short order. Moving in Erickson. Abdelkader backs him up as Marchenko has it for Detroit. He gets it back from Jonathan Erickson. Knocked down there by Bjorkstrand. Red Wings in the midst of a change. Henrik Zetterberg across center and in as Larkin goes after it with Murray. Larkin hauled down by Murray, trying to turn back on him. Calvert, good play by Quincy to stand up at the line. Here's Larkin, pulls it back, and just couldn't finish. He went into the net, that's where he wanted the puck to go. Here's Zetterberg, he gets checked at the line by Calvert. Off the bench came Glenn Denning, and able to steal that puck, and then gets stood up at the Columbus blue line. Just over six to play here in period two. Calvert shook off Quincy. Now for Larkin. Larkin went down at center, checked by Winberg. Danny to Kaiser. Chipped through by Larkin. Red Wings changing. Savard clears it around. Matt Calvert waiting at his own line. Tap back to the line, but kept in by Foligno. Columbus changing as Brendan Smith over to get it. Seth Jones knocking it down. Jackets in. Foligno. And couldn't finish that as Howard stayed with him. Went to his backhand. Savard a shot. Locked in front. Oh, good play by Athanasiou. It was a bouncing puck. Dubinsky was going to whack at it. Back in comes Green. Couldn't get it through to Glendinning. Cleared ahead and it went off the stick of Foligno into Red Wing territory. Green took a hit from Brandon Dubinsky. Came over from the Rangers and part of the Rick Nash deal four seasons ago. Campbell. Datsyuk came back to steal it. Chaput. To the corner now, Datsyuk. Vermantha. Showing the patience of a veteran. Tipped through by Tatar. Lift of the stick on Ramage by Datsyuk. Carlson to Chaput, ahead for Campbell. Gregory Campbell's shot goes off a body. It's loose for Carlson. Loose in the crease. Campbell trying to find it. And Howard says, I have it. In Dominic Hasek-like fashion, has it in his blocker hand. So highlights. When we come back, Carolina and Pittsburgh. Happy St. Patrick's Day from Columbus. Carolina behind Detroit by four. Pittsburgh 3 up on Detroit. You just don't want a three-point game in there as you look at the Red Wings' remaining schedule. And after this night, Philadelphia will have a couple in hand and they will meet Pittsburgh on Saturday. And they've got three more to play those two together.
And that's the key moving forward. No three-point games by either Pittsburgh, Philadelphia, or Carolina, Pittsburgh. Any combination of that, you need these games. The Red Wings need these games won in regulation. Any three-point game is going to make the Red Wings have to win even more games than they have to.
And there is Boone Jenner, our Toyota report card on his NHL career. In a season last year, missed half of it with the back injury, but what a season he's having this year. A power forward, his first 20-goal season. Native is 24 in the power play.
Reminds me a bit of Gallagher from Montreal. Not a huge forward, but plays hard, will go to the net, gets in the gritty areas, and has some offensive ability. Seems to always play well against the Red Wings.
He was drafted in the same draft in which the Red Wings took Thomas Yurko. 22 years old. big hitter. Second round in 2011. Helm back of the net. Helm off Bobrovsky. A backhand by Datsyuk. Didn't get through. Helm goes after it. Golubev. Tony Golubev for the pass ahead to Jenner. He couldn't get past. Moving up is Quincy. Datsyuk going for a change. Nyquist up on the forecheck. Jenner had it poked away by Larkin. Marchenko held the line and kept it in. Good play by Marchenko. Here's Gus Nyquist. To the corner for Zetterberg. Nyquist now changing. He goes off. Jonathan Erickson got a stick on it. Held it in. Murray. Here comes Calvert, and a save by Howard. And Mickey York is sending word that it is 2-2, not 3-2. So that's the good news, right, Mick? That's the good news, that it's still 2-2 Pittsburgh and Carolina.
Well, we don't want Pittsburgh to be leading, obviously. At the same time, we don't want a three-point game, though. We probably would prefer, if that's going to be the case, for Carolina to win that hockey game. Pittsburgh Penguins, even with Malkin out, seem to play better than Crosby. He's been absolutely unbelievable here the second half of the season after a very slow start. Seems that whenever Malkin's out, he rises his game up to the next level.
Yeah, it really was a matter of time. Remember a few months ago, Crosby was something like a 145th in scoring, and now he's got 70 points coming in the game tonight, and he's fifth in NHL points. Centered, and good coverage there by Athanasiou. Knocked down was Richards. Ramage tying it up for Columbus. Wenberg tried to get it deep, couldn't. Athanasiou's got it. Athanasiou with a good move, gets help from Glendening, back to the middle, and just didn't get to Richards as the Blue Jackets come back. Wenberg with it. Alexander Wenberg in, nice poke check by Brendan Smith. Held the line, made the play. In comes Richards. Put it to the corner, Athanasiou in back of the net. Foligno for Columbus. Brendan Smith trying to fend him off. Foligno back to the middle. Hartnell the shot. Howard the save and rolled down his back. He gets some help. As Tatar was there too, Howard made the save. It rolled down but stayed out. Tatar able to get one ahead for Gus Nyquist. And Bobrovsky will hold on. And Savard trying to push Nyquist away from his netminder.
Timely save for Jimmy Howard. Foligno using his skills and his strength against Smith. And great shot here in the slot by Hartnell. And Jimmy Howard makes himself big, takes it off the shoulder, rolls over and gets some help. The Red Wings have been a lot better defensively as coming back and helping their goaltender out, allowing no second chances. They all collapse back towards the blue, give Jimmy Howard some assistance to keeping this puck out after the initial save. To me, the Red Wings look a lot sharper in their own zone, and that's why they're leading this game right now. Jimmy Howard has made some big saves in the second to keep the Wings up.
Puck jammed to the near side. Off Hartnell at center. Came free for Dubinsky as DeKeyser goes back. Got in front of Dubinsky, allowed Shane to come over. Now Nyquist got it to the line, not out. Penalty, though, coming to Columbus. So the Red Wings are going to head to a Bell Tire power play. Dubinsky will try to argue that. Won't matter. As you can enter the Fox Sports Detroit Steel of Spring sweepstakes for a chance to win a new lawn tractor. I think Mickey's going to enter this one. Enter at foxsportsdetroit.com for your chance to win. Redmond's up and running for that right now. That is a Steel of Spring sweepstakes for a chance to win a new lawn tractor. That'll go with the other three he's got in the backyard.
I'm going to go in on that. That tractor's gotten a little old. They could use a new one.
They didn't drop great. That one, right?
That's a big opportunity here for the Red Wings again. Power play late in the second period. If they can somehow cash in on this and get a two-goal lead, it would be huge going to the third.
Levinsky in the box. Red Wings Bell Tire power play. Third try of the game. Two of their 15 shots have come with the man advantage. They win the faceoff. Zetterberg at the point. Redirected in front by Richard. Save by Sergei Bobrovsky.
I like the thought process of this. You win a draw, you go to the net right away. Nice tip play here. Bobrovsky stays on top of that. Richards with a tip and tracking it nicely. Bobrovsky, but the Red Wings, I like what they did there. That's when they're successful with their power plays, when they attack the net right away off these draws, not allowing Columbus to get set up on their penalty kill.
And win another faceoff. Point shot. Ooh. Bobrovsky didn't see it until it was past him as Green let it go. But again, well set up as Mantha helped get it back to the line. Minute to go here in period number two as Zetterberg brings it to center. Drop back for Green. Mantha circles up high with it. Then lost his footing. And as it was played by Carlson for Atkinson. And a save by Howard. Good play again by Carlson. To Atkinson. Knocked down. Mantha. To Zetterberg, and the Red Wings want to change. Larkin coming over the boards along with Tatar. Dylan Larkin with it. Savard for Columbus, checked by Brad Richards. And back down the ice it goes.
I don't think that's what the Red Wings are looking for here on their power play at the end of the second period. Columbus Blue Jackets actually with some opportunities against the Blue Jackets.
Here's Nyquist, gets checked. Five to go in the period. And that'll do it. So a carryover to start the third for Detroit of 36 seconds on the man advantage. But as they were leading after one, they will lead after. Well, as of this moment, as Red Wing fans on this St. Patrick's Day here in Columbus, this the most important 20 minutes of the season for the Red Wings. And at this morning's skate, 19-year-old Bailey Seagraves from Hilliard, Ohio, not far from here, a buddy of the Red Wings, Jeff Salako, who's the Grand Rapids Griffins goaltending coach. Bailey Seagraves plays in the U.S. Premier Hockey League, was to be studying for his ACT test, but said, nope, I get to practice with the Red Wings because Peter Mrazek had the flu and Jared Coral was called up, who will make the trip to Florida. So that's part of our Ram Guts Glory play, as Bailey Seagraves tweeted this, an incredible experience getting to fill in for the Red Wings at the morning skate. I guess, Chris, at age 19, it would be.
That's a dream come true. He was fired up. Saw him afterwards. He was exhausted. Didn't look quite as fired as he did prior to going on the ice, but what an experience. He did well. Made some big saves. Jay Bedard, his assistant, Jeff Salako, put him through the paces pretty good.
So the Red Wings start this third period, and as we say, a very important third period on the power play on the carryover penalty to Brandon Dubinsky. Brendan Smith. Zetterberg now. Abdelkader couldn't get to it. It was behind him. And Columbus clears it down. Green coming with speed through the middle. Mike Green into the Blue Jacket zone and lost the puck. As Dubinsky out of the box, Datsyuk back to pick it up. Mike Green for Brendan Smith to Henrik Zetterberg. Just dumped it down ice. No icing though. Cody Golubev back. Off the skate of Nyquist. So the Jackets will try the other way and now turn back with it. Golubev again. Played by Murray out to center ice. Here comes Atkinson. Drop back for Dubinsky. Checked by Sheahan. Brandon Dubinsky to the line for Murray. Sailed up into the netting and a stop in play. Goal in this game came in the opening period. Glendening deflecting a Sheahan shot. His first in 22 games. Jimmy Howard's had a good night. And Anthony Mantha has played a couple more minutes than he did in, or a couple of minutes still under his debut of a few nights ago, but should pass it when he played 14:45. Panthers had a few opportunities, one off the skate of the referee Kyle Raymond, and he was in alone on Bobrovsky, but was in tight. Really didn't have much room to move. Unless he had tried a Michael Roffel move from Philadelphia the other night, it would have been the play to make. Easy to say from
up
here.
It was an impressive goal
from
the red line in. That inside position on Quincy did a nice finish and had a great finish on Peter Mrazek.
Brandon Saad gets checked. Richards ahead for Andreas Athanasiou. Athanasiou, a good play to literally try to jump past the defender Ramage. Good closure there at center by Marchenko. But carrying back in is Bjorkstrand. Couldn't get through. Now Falk will fire it in for Columbus. Both teams in the midst of changing. Just over two played here in period three. Ken Daniels, Chris Osgood with you. Glad you're with us tonight from Nationwide Arena in Columbus. No icing. Helm moving up along with Mantha. Anthony Mantha's got it. That 6-5 frame kept in here by Green for Helm again. Helm got hit hard by Savard. Carried ahead by Seth Jones. Green is checked. Jimmy Howard pushed it off to the corner. Pavel Datsyuk for Helm. Couldn't catch up to it. Hit Datsyuk again. Datsyuk will lead Helm. And he couldn't get it. Just bounced away from him. He and Mantha would have been in. Dubinsky for Foligno. Checked at the line by Brendan Smith. Too far for Green. To the corner for Carlson. Took the shot. Howard the same. Green lifted it out to center. Then follows up. Then lost it. Carlson took a hit from Applicator. To Kaiser for Quincy. Chopped at by Zetterberg. Not out. Ryan Murray, the defenseman, then couldn't get it into the middle as Zetterberg had it. And he'll reverse that. Larkin got it over to Zetterberg across center. Zetterberg into Blue Jackets territory, turned over at their blue line as Calvert sent it across, and he got the center, so no icing. Punch back out by Quincy to the line. Ramage couldn't keep it in. Tomas Tatar will try. Sheehan off the bench. Skate the stick, he's got it. Then shoots it. It's blocked. Alexei Marchenko playing his third straight game. Once again tonight, Yurko and Polkinen are scratched for Detroit. We mentioned earlier, Cronwall, hopefully close to returning. Maybe at some point on the Florida trip, as Jeff Blasher was talking about this morning. He did take the pregame warm-up. This will be icing against the Red Wings. Just a reminder, as you enjoy a cold one, to look forward to Miller Time later in tonight's game, brought to you by Miller Lite.
Red Wings much more organized in their own zone here tonight than they have been of late. Really supporting each other well, getting pucks out in a hurry, not having any of those turnovers that we've seen here in the last couple of weeks.
Good take there by Athanasiou, sent the rest of the way by Glenn Denning. Richards the other forward on this line. Nick Foligno. Around to Seth Jones. Here's Foligno on the right wing side. Left hand shot. It went off to Kaiser to the far corner. Athanasiou gets bumped. Scott Hartnell couldn't get to it. Smith finds Richards but threw it right back in behind. And Glenn Denning has to go after it. Checked by Hartnell. And Hartnell and Smith battle. Puck came free in front of the net. This time, Richards makes sure to clear it, but now it results in an icing. So all that, Brad Richards had the first opportunity to get out of the zone, went back with it, never did, and now results in an icing charge against Detroit. The Red Wings, as you see, after tonight, Philadelphia will have two in hand. So this is how imperative this one is, as the Red Wings can leapfrog past the Flyers. Pittsburgh in a lead over Carolina tonight. Carolina As you can see, just four back of Detroit games even. Pittsburgh three up on the Red Wings. And Detroit, after that icing, has called timeout. So with that, we'll take a timeout. See you in 30 seconds. Face off Detroit zone. There. He's got the green tie today. No ties in hockey anymore. No ties to go with those blue jackets. Sent ahead for Glendening. Chris, contain yourself. Another icing against Detroit.
Yeah, these are big faceoffs here in the defensive zone for the Red Wings. You got to get away from icing the puck here. They're going to give the Columbus Blue Jackets some momentum. They don't want that. Columbus hasn't scored for a while. They look like they're frustrated. They're shut out last game, so now over five periods without a goal. They want to give them some unnecessary opportunities to try and get off the slide there and get their first in a while.
So now a broken stick. Zafanasiu will get a new composite there from Paul Boyer. Well, buys the Red Wings some more time. Well, they should have recovered from all that and went with the timeout. That should be fine. Now they have to get the puck out of their zone. Jenner on the draw with Glendening spinning around. It came to the middle and Jones is first on it. Back into the middle for Atkinson and Howard the save, and the Red Wings will now be able to make a change.
That was big time rebound control by Jimmy Howard. The reason for that is, obviously, you get a line change. And Jimmy Howard not giving up a rebound, making sure he corralled that in the stomach area, and that allows Red Wings to get some fresh troops out there, much needed. You got to start playing in Columbus's zone here. 14 minutes left in the third. They don't want to be stuck. Give Columbus some opportunities at a good break or a bad bounce the Red Wings' way.
And they will have another icing, and they had Alexander Winberg. John Tortorella has him come out against Pavel Datsyuk. He elected to make a change as well, and Wenberg just 21 years old. Centerman up against Datsyuk, and as we say, that's all part of what the Blue Jackets are doing this year, putting players in different situations to see what they can do. And now against Datsyuk coming in to take it, Brandon Saad, and won by Pavel. Mantha tried to kick it out, couldn't do it. And finally out to center ice. Saad back for Ryan Murray. Murray, who's starting his career, was slowed by injuries, but healthy this year as Columbus goes offside. And with that, we'll step out. It continues to be Red Wings 1, Blue Jackets nothing in a very important game. Well, less than 1 year from the start of mass excavation, construction of the new Detroit Event Center, future home of the Red Wings, progressing as expected with all eyes focused on September 2017. The first roof truss was put in place yesterday in anticipation of the completion of the structural steel work this fall. Red Wing flag flying high. And the Detroit Event Center, so it was a good winter to get a lot of work done. Keep the schedule going. Abdelkader, Zetterberg, and Larkin. Marchenko is there before Saad could get to the puck. Murray back for Jones. And he went off Larkin. Picked up here by Abdelkader, then knocked off his stick. Jones weaving his way into the Detroit zone. Then forced back by Abdelkader. Marchenko trying to cover. Put back in behind by Bjorkstrand. And Bjorkstrand playing in his first NHL game. Big scorer in junior hockey. Here comes Abdelkader. Marchenko with him in Zetterberg. Abdelkader waits. Zetterberg rebound. Scores! Henrik Zetterberg! 2-0, collecting an applicator rebound.
Not a lot of chances for the Red Wings, but they make good on this one. The captain, Henrik Zetterberg, who I think has been one of the best players for the Red Wings tonight. Applicator takes his net, goes off the Columbus Blue Jackets defenseman, Stick Bobrovsky. Hits him in the pad, he can't find it quick enough. Comes across, but he's not elevated. He doesn't have his shoulders up. Applicator looking to pass all the way. Elects to it, off the stick, and Bobrovsky shuffles aside. He hasn't played a lot. He's been injured all season. Usually he'd come across, upward more. He couldn't do it there. He was leaning forward. Henrik Zetterberg puts it over the pad. Huge goal.
His 13th and his first goal in 13 games.
Couldn't come at a better time. Zetterberg's been great in his own end tonight, great in the faceoff circle. His all-around game is always good. Now he's contributing offensively as well with a huge goal here.
So a long time coming, but a big-time goal from the Red Wings captain. 2-0 lead for the Red Wings, a little bit of breathing room. To the other side, forward to pick it up is Justin Falk. Blue Jackets work it in down low. They center, taken away though by Nyquist. Nyquist looking for his first goal in six. Along with Tatar. Tatar needs one for a 20-goal season. He led the team last year with 29. Nyquist off his stick at center. Athanasiou helped out and now turns up ice with it. Here comes Athanasiou like a fullback trying to bust through. And then Jones got him. Jones readjusts the helmet. And it's blocked by Foligno. They stumble trying to get out as Hartnell. Down again. Here comes Athanasiou, and a piece of that by Bobrovsky. Knocked down here by Foligno. Nick Foligno waits, took a shot. Howard the save, the rebound to Calvert. Big crowd in front. Datsyuk comes up with it for Detroit. Loops one down ice that Bobrovsky will be forced to hold as Helm was coming at him. Abdelkader and Larkin draw the assist on Zetterberg's 13th at 7:16, the scoring play. And with that goal at 3:09 on this St. Patrick's Day, he used to play the Irish Jake for Shanny at the Joe. He ties Brendan Shanahan in the all-time leading goal scorers for the Red Wings. Golubov hit by DeKaiser. Quincy didn't come around for Helm on the first try. Kept in again by Golubov, and the shot tipped in wide. Murray back in front off the skate of Datsyuk. Cam Atkinson. DeKaiser chases with Jenner. Quincy. And Helm in back of the net. Helm tried to get it back to Quincy. He couldn't. And then Pavel Datsyuk knocks it down. Slip one ahead for Mantha, allowing the Red Wings to get a change. Approaching the halfway point here of period number three. That's offside. As the Red Wings desperate for 2 points here in Columbus. And a reminder, you can be part of the farewell season at the Joe. If you place a small deposit on 2016-17 season ticket plans, you'll get priority access to seating locations in the new Detroit Events Center we showed you and other exclusive benefits. For more information, go to DetroitRedWingsSeasonTickets.com. Kaiser reversed that for Brendan Smith for Abdelkader. Gets it off the skate of the linesman and out to center ice. Back in this time onside for Brandon Saad and a save by Jimmy Howard. So with that, we'll take a break. You're watching Red Wings Hockey on Fox Sports Detroit presented by Falcon.
He was in part in the second. But let's take a look at Big Boy's big play of the game. And Dylan Larkin right here takes a hit. in the corner to make a play. It's a big play. It's an underrated play. Dylan Larkin, a nice play to get that up to Abdelkader, who comes in off the stick, and Zetterberg follows it up and puts it home for the win, second goal. But this is a nice play here. He knows he's going to get hit. He takes a hit. He gets the puck up to Abdelkader. Plays like that that sometimes happen a long ways away from the net, but have something to do with the goal that eventually goes in. Nice play by Larkin.
And a loose puck here. And here comes the speed of Helm. Helm's in the shot and just missed far side. Here comes Datsyuk, though. Datsyuk, tried to center one. And it was knocked down before it could get to Helm. Marchenko in back of the net. He sent it. Datsyuk gets knocked down. Atkinson put it in front, went off a skate. Jonathan Erickson. A bouncing puck into Columbus territory. In goes Larkin, checked by Jones. Quincy got in front of Winberg, who stayed with it though. Winberg got all turned around. Under nine to play here. In period number three. Quincy. Zetterberg knocked it down. Larkin goes after it, Bobrovsky to play it. Abdelkader got a stick on it, able to wheel it back in for Larkin. Larkin lost it, put it back in front again, and an attempted pass for Riley Sheahan. Alexander Winberg for the Blue Jackets. Winberg with 6 goals and 29 points, all career highs for him. John Tortorella says he'll be his project in the offseason and thinks he's going to be a very good hockey player. The scary part becomes when you're Tortorella's project. You better perform.
That's a little pressure, isn't it?
A little bit.
Just a little bit.
It'll make you better. That'll be held by Bobrovsky. Sunday NASCAR Sprint Cup Racing heads to Fontana with the Auto Club 400 on Fox as Brad Keselowski, Rochester Hills, Michigan, looks to defend his title from last year. You don't see him here, but he's a good one. It's all Sunday at 3 Eastern only on Fox and streaming live on Fox Sports Go. Point shot by Green off the back of the net. Brendan Smith checked. And the Red Wings content just to make sure they get it out of the zone. Not a bad idea. Here comes Helm is in. Scores! Darren Helm! He went over the blocker of Bobrovsky. And it's 3-0 Detroit. 7:25 away from a huge 2 points in Columbus.
For all the chances Darren Helm gets, he scores on this one. But this is hard work by Glenn Denning. He makes it happen here and goes to the net with the puck and gets it on the net. Those are the two things he always does very well. Uses his speeder, doesn't sit back, doesn't turn up. He takes us right to the slot area, shoots it through a bunch of sticks, which might have thrown off Bobrovsky just enough. Might have been deflected as well, but you see two Blue Jackets have their sticks in there right near Helm's stick. And as a goaltender, that fools around with your eyesight a little bit. Might have got deflected, but Helm, good job of getting on his horse, getting the speed up, getting into the slot area, and getting that puck on the net.
Well, Darren Helm, who had 2 goals, including the winner against the Rangers, and then was ill for a game and didn't finish the next one at Philadelphia because he was ill. Feel a lot better now, as do the Red Wings, with a 3-goal advantage here in Columbus. And after the Red Wings, still, they haven't scored more than 3 in regulation in 39 of the last 43 games. So to get 3 tonight, however they get them, is huge.
And be up 3-0 has got to be a first in a long, long time. So that must feel nice as well here with 7 minutes left. You still got to play the right way. But they have all game long. This is like the Ranger game. They've got pucks deep. They've got on the Columbus Blue Jacket defense. They haven't allowed them to get on their defense, get their forecheck going. Columbus against Detroit, they're doing a good job of getting in their zone. This is mirrored the Ranger game in a lot of ways.
In comes Atkinson, and That was deflected. I don't know if that caught part of the post or not. But up and out of play.
Helm comes in defensive, Ramage, the young defenseman, gets a stick in there. It's going to ramp right up here. Just enough to throw Bobrovsky off. Right off the crossbar and into the net. Bobrovsky hasn't played a lot, so he's rusty as well. I think this is just his third game back. I believe if he was playing all year, he probably would have that. But Helm did a nice job to get that puck on the net and really drive to the goal, not turn up and create a turnover.
Here it is to Jones. Good save there by Howard. Jones with it. Lost it. Feeds it across. Savard. Matsuk tapped it over for Helm. A lift of the stick of Dubinsky. And here comes DeKaiser. DeKaiser's got Glendening with him. DeKaiser trying to go back to Glendening, but Jones coming back hit a skate. And that's swept away by Datsuk from Dubinsky. So the Red Wings don't have a number 42 in their lineup, but they got goals from numbers 40, 41, and 43 tonight. And it's 3-0.
It's impressive, Kent. It really is.
The addition or the goals?
The addition.
Symmetry. Here comes Sheehan. And that'll be held by Bobrovsky, and then Foligno gets a shot in there just because he thought he could. Under six to play in the third. Red Wings by three. Over the.
It's Miller time, brought to you by Miller Lite. Jimmy Howard, unexpected starter this morning. Team Mazza goes in. This is it right here. Big save off Hartnell. 20 goal score for the Jackets. Off the shoulder. Get some help from Green, from Shane. But Jimmy Howard didn't know he's playing until this morning. He has looked solid. Tracking pucks. This was 1-0 at the time, so this was a big save. If it's 1-1, this game could be different. So Jimmy Howard has made big saves at the right time. The Jackets only have had 5 scoring chances all night, but when they have, Jimmy Howard has made them, especially when it was 1-0.
Drop back to the line here for Green. Walk the line over to Smith, and a save, Bobrovsky. William Karlsson. Worked its way over this side for Murray. Back Carlson's way. Brendan Smith was there. Hit Carlson. So Smith has it again. Taking no chances. Just wrapped it off the boards and out the center with 5.5 to go in the third period. Red Wings Smith stepped up on Saad. Red Wings defense done a nice job with the blue line tonight. Not giving the Blue Jackets much room.
They've stood up at the blue line, Ken. They haven't given that gap up. The room they had been giving up, but they've been well out in the neutral zone as well. Their forwards, the centerman has been above the puck, has been above the play. They've been great defensively from not only the neutral zone, but in their own zone as well. And when they do get the puck, they're getting it out right away. They haven't had those turnovers.
And remember, yes, the Blue Jackets are near the bottom of the standings. However, they've been very good lately since John Tortorella took over. Oh, as the Red Wings found out last week, far from a pushover. And they've dominated the Red Wings of late, 10-2-2, their past 14 meetings with Detroit. Turn it over here as Helm put it off Bobrovsky. And in this building, 6-1-1, their past 8 against the Red Wings. So coming in here and getting the edge on Columbus, still 4.5 to play, has not been an easy task for the visitors.
They just haven't let them get their pace. The Red Wings have taken away time and space all night long from the Blue Jackets. They've done a good job defensively as well and really protected Jimmy Howard nicely.
And Savard has it. And further to what Columbus has done, they've lost their last two. First time in nearly 2 months they've had back-to-back losses. Blue Jackets have points in 15 of their past 21 games, including 2 huge points they took from Detroit in here. Red Wings beat Columbus in a shootout earlier this season. Marchenko out at center in the midst of a change was Campbell turning around and able to knock it away before Nyquist could get there. Marchenko awkwardly though able to keep control momentarily, and a second try. It came back to the point here for Golubov. Over to Falk. That shot just skipped wide of the goal. Golubov moved in for Columbus. Henrik Zetterberg got position. And then the Jackets come up with it. to the line. It comes for Golubev. Howard down, save, off a skate, and just wide. Marchenko hit a stanchion as Marchenko got rocked in the corner. Then Zetterberg shoved his man and then gets shoved back by Davinsky, who goes after Zetterberg again, and Zetterberg gave him a whack with the stick. In comes Atkinson now. Atkinson, a backhander. Howard the save. Diving back, a hold on.
Jimmy Howard's been solid when called upon tonight. And again, here at Sweet Nothing, and Jimmy Howard's making some big saves to make sure this game doesn't become a doubt, shuffling across, and just trickles wide. That's a break Jimmy Howard wasn't getting a month ago. Now he is, and this is a big save right here. Finds it through traffic. Nice use of his eyes to track that puck and then able to cover it up, but Columbus Blue Jackets. Whenever you're up 3-0, you have to expect the opposition is going to get a little bit of a push. So as a goaltender, you know you're going to see a little more action here in the last 3 minutes. The Red Wings got to make sure. You don't want to give one, give any type of breathing or any type of life at all.
And in Pittsburgh, the Penguins with a 4-2 lead over Carolina with about 6 to play in that game. Again, the Penguins 3 up on the Red Wings coming into play tonight. The Red Wings need 2 to keep pace and vault past Philadelphia into the second wild card spot, and the Flyers will have 2 in hand on Detroit after tonight.
Well, by the time Detroit plays in Florida, Philadelphia will play Pittsburgh in that afternoon game, 1 o'clock. It's a huge game.
Here's Larkin up high with it. The shot knocked off to the corner, and you're thinking, you know, 2 tonight will go to that, 2 points. The Red Wings, with the games remaining, pretty much at worst, 8-4.
They have to go 8-4, 8-3-1,
something like
in that fashion.
9-3 would be preferable.
It's a nervous time, but it's also an exciting time. I think these players have to embrace it and have fun with it, go out and play, just win. And tonight, I think they played a lot looser than they have of late. They played the right way.
And yes, 2 big games coming up against the Panthers and the Lightning. Saturday and next Tuesday. Fox Sports Detroit Plus Saturday night. Tuesday, Fox Sports Detroit from Tampa Bay. And Steve Yzerman's group. And Terry Filppula out of their lineup. He's been hurt. Stamkos has really come on. Carried back in here for Athanasiou. 1:20 to go. In come the Jackets, and a penalty upcoming to Detroit with 1:11 left.
Yeah, Brendan Smith's going to go off here.
Detroit penalty number 2. 2 minutes hooking.
And the next 5 games for the Red Wings. Saturday night, Fox Sports Detroit Plus. And then from Tampa on Tuesday, and then home to Montreal and Pittsburgh and Buffalo. And
you say the Montreal Canadiens are coming in, they're a team that's struggling. Well, it's never easy to come home and play a game after you've been on the road for a while. That 4 games the Red Wings will be on the road for. Montreal, they always play the Red Wings tough as well. They played well in Joe Louis Arena. The big game against Pittsburgh should be a great one.
So, big penalty kill here for Detroit. Howard the save on Jenner. Loose in front of the net. Wennberg scores. Well, the penalty cost Jimmy Howard what could have been a shutout that he started the season with against Toronto, and that's too bad for him.
Yeah, that's really disappointing that Blue Jackets were able to break the shutout for Jimmy Howard. Just off the draw here, win draw, they take it right to him. This is what the Jackets usually do. The Red Wings have been really good at defending this type of play from the Jackets. Right here, they get through defense. Yes, the Red Wings are shorthanded. Jackets did a good job of sending everybody to the goal. Lou Jenner banging away, and then Weinberg was able to put in the rebound afterwards. But Jimmy Howard, although losing the shutout to me, has been really solid tonight. Back on his game, really, for over a 2-3 span now. I think he's looked really, really good. That's a plus for the Red Wings moving forward.
First goal in a couple of games for the Blue Jackets as well, after they were coming off a shutout loss.
Wenberg
getting the power play goal. Columbus shut out by the Tampa Bay Lightning, 4-0 here. And now Bobrovsky goes to the bench for an extra skater. It bounced off Jones. Net empty for Columbus. And sent down by Larkin. It'll be wide, so it'll be icing against the Red Wings. And Detroit had already used their timeout. Wenberg scoring from Atkinson and Jenner at the 19-minute mark.
Ludo, mind that play by Larkin to get that out. You have a two-goal lead, one-goal lead. Maybe not, but two-goal lead. Just get it out. You won't have turnover in front of your net. And a quick goal against to put him within one. Get that puck out, ice it down, get regrouped, and win a draw here.
Well, now John Tortorella will use his timeout. So with that, we'll take 1-2. The Red Wings up by two with 26 seconds. Their timeout is 24 goal scorer Cam Atkinson. Ready to face Jimmy Howard. Jackets down by two. About chunk the Red Wings by five. Net empty. Six skaters for the Jackets. They get it back to the line. Ooh, and that came close in on Howard. And a shot from the point. Back of the net, Quincy. Broken stick for the Red Wings. Zetterberg doesn't have one. 12 seconds left. To the other side, Abdelkader getting over on Jones. Came free to Atkinson. Atkinson shooting! And tipped, hit a body and wide. And this game is over. The Red Wings win it, 3-1. Their first win in three games and two big points for Detroit. Their third win, their past eight, and a big victory here in Columbus, and a big game from Jimmy Howard. An update at standings now as they move past Philadelphia. The Pittsburgh game with Carolina is not yet complete. 3.5 minutes left in that game, so Pittsburgh, if they hang on up by a couple, will move to 84 points, still three up on Detroit.